Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytunes.com. In the last two episodes, we set up a 12-page brochure document and placed in all the images and textures. In this video, we are going to continue developing the document and I'm going to bring in all the type and demonstrate how we can manage this. If you're new to this course, I suggest you watch the two previous episodes to see how this document was developed up to this point, before watching this tutorial. So with the project folder open, navigate to the Design Process folder. In that, I'm going to open the Design Process PDF. So here are my ideas for the brochure and how I develop the layouts we are currently working on in InDesign. So focusing on the compositions for the front and back, here on the cover, I aim to place a small title in the bottom left, and the website details under the logo on the back. Looking at my ideas for the spread layouts, we can see I plan to place type in the spaces between the images and the stroke textures. This is just a simple brochure, so not a lot of type here. This will work comfortably around the design. So in InDesign, I have the document open from the last episode and I'm going to start to place my type into the spread on page 4 and 5. So looking at the finished document, we can see that we have a quote in a particular type style. The body has a type style, we have a subheader type style, and a style for the bullets. So let's take a look at how this was set up. So back in the document, I'll make sure that the type layer is selected in the layers panel. I'll come over to the menu and select the frame tool. So in the canvas area, I'll focus on the second page. I'll click and drag a frame out like so, beginning on the left inside margin and dragging across to meet the middle of the column on the right. Then I'll drag another one, but this time down inside the left column. So these two frames are ready to enter in some type. So in the project folder, I'll navigate to the project assets folder. In that, I'll open the copy folder and open the brochure copy document. This is the copy that has been supplied to us to include in the brochure. So I'll begin by coming to spread 1. I'll select the quote type and I'll copy this and come back into InDesign. I'll select the type tool, click into the top frame and paste. So now the type needs formatting. So I'll select all the type, come up to the control panel. In the font name, I'll type open. From the selection, I'll select Open Sans Light Italic. In the font size, I'll change this to 20 points. I'll click on the All Caps icon, just right of the type size. I'll make sure the font color is selected down in the menu and change the font color to Synergy Purple. I'll choose the Selection tool to deselect the type and then click off to deselect the type frame. I'll press W to take a look in preview mode. So currently, that type is looking a little tight there. Next, I'm going to add some space. To do this, I'll tweak the leading and the tracking. So with the selection tool, I'll select the type frame and double click to select the type inside the frame. With the type selected, I'll set the leading to 28 and press enter, and then I'll set the tracking to 100. I'll place my mouse cursor before the word begins and click to place the type prompt. Then, press and hold shift and press enter to create a line break. I'll do the same for engineering to add a line break and for the word ends. So that's looking much better. So in normal mode, I'll choose a selection tool and select the top of the type box and drag to the top of the inside margin. I'll drag the bottom of the type box down to meet the top of the image. Next, I'll come up into the control panel and click the Align Center button. So that will position the quote perfectly between the inner margin and the top of the image. So this document is a lot more complex than the previous business card and letterhead we created earlier in the course. We will be using various type styles throughout the brochure. So on this occasion, it would be wise to use character styles. Now, if you're not sure what character styles are, don't worry, you're about to find out. So I'm going to come in and select this type here, and now I'm going to come over and activate my character styles panel. If you don't see yours, come up to Window, scroll down and activate yours there. So in the top right menu, I'll click this and choose New Character Style. So in the new character style menu box, I'll name this quote. Now on the left are all the properties we can change. Now because we selected the type before clicking new character style, all the format properties are set up here for us. For example, if I click on basic character formats, we can see over on the right the font, style, size, leading, tracking, and so on are all set to the quote style we just formatted. So I'll click OK. So that character style will be saved, and we can use this later when we put in more quote text. And at a click of a button, we can format the type. So back in the copy document, this time I'm going to select the remaining type for this page, including the bullet points. I'll come back into InDesign, select the type tool, click once inside the type frame below and paste. Once pasted in, again, I will have to format the type. So with all the type selected, I'll come up to the control panel, type open into the font. I'll select Open Sans Regular. I'll set the font size to 9 points. I'll set the leading to 14, and I'll set the font color to white. I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type and click off to deselect the type frame. So here is the body copy, but now I need to format the subheader and the bullet points. So I'll click the type frame and double click to select the type inside. I'll start by changing the font color of the type below to Synergy Purple. Then I'll just select the subheader and change the font to bold and the font size to 11, and I'll click on the all caps icon. Next, I'll click before the words services and press and hold shift and press enter for a line break. So next I'll come to the bullet copy and remove the hyphens before each point like so. Then I'll select all the points, come up to the control panel and click the bullet list icon to apply bullets. So now I'm happy with the type. Now I'm going to create more character styles. So I'll come and select the copy text. I'll come into the character styles panel, click the menu and select new character style. I'll call this body copy and click OK. Next, I'll select the header and do the same. And I'll call this character style subhead. Great. So that completes the type setting for this page. Now, once we have created character styles, adding type to the rest of the brochure is really easy. So on the next spread, I'll select the rectangle frame tool and draw some new frames for the type. This time, I'll draw one on the left page placed bottom left, and I'll place a frame in the right column on the right page. I'll come into the copy document, select the quote, come back into the InDesign file. With the type tool, I'll click into the frame on the left page and paste. Now this time, with the copy selected, instead of formatting the type manually like we did before, if I now come into the character style and click on quote, just like that, the style is now applied. Pretty cool, right? So the style also includes the color, but that's not a problem. Now the style has been applied, we simply select the type and change the color. In this instance, I'll change the color to white. Now, in this type frame, you can see we have a hyphen here. To prevent any hyphenation happening, with the type selected, simply come up to the control panel and uncheck the hyphenate box. This will then prevent type from hyphenating in that type frame. So I'll come in and apply line breaks where I see fit, and that's looking nice. So I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type, but with the frame still selected, I'll click the Align Center button up in the control panel. So I'll come into the copy document, select the rest of the copy for this spread. In InDesign, I'll use the type tool to click into the other frame and paste. With all the types selected, I'll come into the character style and click the body copy style. Next, I'll select the subhead and apply the subhead character style. On this occasion, I'll select the bottom paragraph type and change it to the Synergy Purple. I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type, but with the frame still selected, I'll click the middle top point and drag down to align with the top of the triangle, like so. So once happy, I'll move on to the next spread. So just like earlier, I'll draw some frames with the rectangle frame tool where I want to place some type. One on the left page and two on the right page. Then I'll come into the copy document, I'll select the quote, come into InDesign, use the type tool to click into the frame and paste. I'll come back into the copy doc, select the first lot of copy, and I'll copy this. Back into InDesign, I'll paste. But this time we have a problem. Now there is too much type to fit in this frame, and we can see a little red box indicating this. So with the selection tool, I'll click on this red box. My mouse cursor will indicate I can now create a new frame to extend. So I'll click into the column to the right and draw another frame. Upon release, the copy will continue from the first frame on the left and now into this new frame on the right. Back into the copy document, I'll select the last bit of copy and paste into the last frame in InDesign. So I'll select all the type in the first two frames and select the body copy character style. Then I'll select the subhead and change that to the subhead style. Notice how we have hyphenation happening again. I'll press Command A to select all the type and come up to the control panel and uncheck the hyphenate box. So currently the subhead is in the Synergy purple. So I'll just select and change to Platonic blue. I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type. On this occasion, I'll change the color of the type in the second frame to Platonic blue. So next, I'll come and select the type in the next frame and set it to the body copy character style. I'll remove all the hyphens from the list. Then, with the list selected, I'll click on the bullet list icon up in the control panel. I'll press Command A to select all the type and change the color to Platonic blue. I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type. Next, I'll come and select the type in the last frame and click the quote character style and change the font color to Platonic blue. I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type and I'll press W to take a look in preview mode. So that's looking okay, but I'm not happy with the type frames at the bottom. I'm thinking the quote is too close to the design element above. Now in normal mode, we can see that the frames on the left and on the right extend to the bottom margin. So I'll press Shift and select both frames. With them both selected, I'll come up into the control panel and select the Align Bottom button in the control panel. Now, if I press W to preview, this is looking much better. So once happy, I'll move on to the final spread. So looking at the finished document, we can see here that the copy follows the same format as on the previous spread. As an example, pause the video and try and create this composition in your document. If you cannot remember how this was done, rewind the video and follow along. Soon you will have something that looks like this. So that completes the copy on the contents pages. Let's now come back up to the index page. So I'll draw a new frame in the bottom right corner, come back into the copy document and select the page index. With the type tool, click into the frame and paste in the type. Now since we have the character style set up, to this I'll apply the body copy style. But for the index type, I'll change the font to semi-bold up in the control panel. And I'll click the all caps button. So because this is the index, on this occasion, I'll change the color of the fonts accordingly. These will match up with the color on the contents pages. So to the top two, I'll set the color to Synergy Purple, and to the bottom two, I'll set the color to Platonic Blue. So I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type, but with the frame still selected, I'll click the Align Bottom button in the control panel. This will sit the type neatly along the bottom margin. With the box still selected, I'll click the middle top point and drag down for a nice fit. So I'll copy and paste this box and place just above. I'll come into the copy document, select the header section, back into InDesign, I'll select the type inside and paste to replace this. So I'll select the type and change to light grey. I'll select 2015, change the font size to 20 points, change the font to light, and the color to Synergy Purple. So I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type. Click off and press W to take a look in preview mode. And that's looking just fine. So with the selection tool, I'll select the title type frame on top and I'll copy this. I'll come to the cover. Now, over in the Pages panel, I'll click the Cover page, then come up to Layout, scroll down and click Margins and Columns. For this page only, I'll set the top, bottom, left and right margin to 13mm and click OK. Then I'll paste the type frame from the index and I'll place this in the bottom left corner, placed nicely over the color texture behind. Now if I press W to enter into normal mode, that should look nice and neat, with the title placed comfortably in the shape behind with adequate margin around. So now comes the last type element. So I'll scroll down to the back cover, press W to make sure I'm back in normal mode, and just draw a wide yet short frame. So I'll come into the copy document and copy the back copy element, the web address. I'll come into InDesign, click into the frame with the type tool and paste in the address. I'll select the type and apply the body copy character style. With the type selected, I'll come up into the control panel and click the align center button. I'll set the font color to light gray and choose the selection tool to deselect the type. With the frame still selected, I'll click the align bottom button and drag the frame to touch the bottom margin like so. I'll select the logo, press W to enter into preview mode and move up like so into a suitable position. And that's looking just fine. Once you've finished, press Command S to save your document. So that's how to add type and use character styles to conveniently format the type in your brochure. Now we are ready to export this document for print. Next, we are going to move into the last section of this course, export and printing. In the next video, we are going to learn how to export your documents in Adobe InDesign ready for print. In the next video, we are going to come back to the business card, letterhead, and this brochure and learn how to export them ready for print. See you in the next video.